is, I mean, he made two spines before he made his gas. And I sniped two drones with zerglings. And he made like three evo chambers, and like, he must have droned the perfect amount, the flawless amount. It was incredible. Really incredible. Like, you know, almost like he had map hack, and I'm not at all saying he was hacking. Like, I think he was just damn good. So, I give him a virtual handshake. But yeah, like, I couldn't get my banelings through. I was planning on just baning away. Okay, here's a Terran guide that's on. This is what I wanted to do. Hey, man, yeah, it's been ages. It has been freaking forever. I've been playing a lot in the last 2 weeks. I took, like, a year off. Like, a year, maybe a year and a half more. No, he did not get link speed, to my knowledge. I'll explain my ZVT style, because it's kind of unique. Which makes me really excited that it's by far my best matchup. Like, I think this is the only place I could actually be relevant to the community at the moment. But, yeah, like, his roaches and queens were positioned just amazingly to kind of choke up my stuff so I couldn't get my banes in. Like, my banes didn't end up killing his spines. My roaches did. Slightly late overlord. Okay, let me talk about my ZVT. I hope I don't just completely fail now after talking it up so much, but I might. It's always a possibility. It is almost exactly... Oh, someone told me that recently. I need to change it to HOTS. I completely forgot. Sorry. Especially if you came looking for someone playing Wings of Liberty. I apologize. Alright, so anyway, really, 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 really similar. Whoops. To, what am I doing? Yakety Sax needs to be playing for that drone. To this three-hatch muta style in Brood War, which, if you guys don't know, was the style popularized by one of the best Zergs ever. So good, like, untouchable. You know, like, Flash and Jadong? Sure, he's not going to be as good as Flash or Jadong, but he had an era where he was the ruler. He was the King Starcraft player, and he was way more dominant than either Flash or Jadong was. Like, his win percentage in all the matchups was like, overall, his win percentage was the highest ever when he was dominant. In fact, the term bone draw, which, you know, came to mean, like, super dominant player, I believe was not coined until him, Savior. But anyway, so he'd go get two bases, and instead of going lurkers, or, you know, essentially what the main ground units are used against Terran Bio, he would get all the gas on his two bases, and he would add a third hatchery for larva production, because remember in Brood War, there was no larva inject. And then sometime he would take his third base, sometime between when the mutas actually came out. Ooh, my queens are a little late, although now they're perfectly in sync, so no biggie, but... I hate being cross because it's so important that I scout where the Terran is. So anyway, that's what I'm doing in this. Of course, I don't have three hatches. I have two hatches and two queens, but it's essentially a macro muta opening. That's the best way I can describe it. He's almost certainly... Well, I don't know. I actually don't know what he's doing. And there's my lair. Pretty much right away, make the lair. And I'm getting a second queen to be defensive. Unfortunately, in this game, I don't know if he's one basing, so nope, no ling speed. Nope, I play ground. I transition to ground. By the way, this is not a cheese or an all-in, I promise. I swear to God, I got so cocky after I got used to doing the build that I would tell people what I was doing. I'd say, hey, my spire's down at 6 minutes and 30 seconds. I'll have mutas to your base at 9 minutes. Try not to die, you know. And I pretty much kill them anyway, like, it's just... The mutas, by the way, don't need to do a ton of damage. They don't. Cluster is under attack. Oh, you bitch. Evolution complete. So, it is... around 6:10 my spire went down. I'm a bit nervous about the roaches, I'm not gonna lie. Not the roaches, you know what I mean. Oh, I should just spread creep with my overlord, although that will give away that I have lair tech, but... I'm gonna take a risk. If he pokes up the ramp right now, I'll be in trouble. Okay, now just some time... oh my god, I'm so bad at supply blocking myself. What in the hell? I'm gonna go ahead and toss down my third now, because I have the minerals too. Like, depending what I've had to do, I won't have the minerals until after the mutas come out, but in this case I do. I want a few more drones. Ah, no, okay, actually I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna just have this guy chill. Okay, so I have the minerals saved. And here, 7 mutas made before 8 minutes. Pretty sick. And all I do with these, once again, is I'm going to use them for map control. And now, I'm going to take a third and a fourth. I'm not all-inning. What did you do against Reapers? Just Queens. I mean, you know, I keep making Queens. Queens are great against Reapers. Now I get Ling Speed. Now I get a Baneling Nest. Now I get an Evolution Chamber. And I'll keep adding on Muta. Widow Mines are really, really dangerous, obviously, and I need to be careful with those. Our forces are under attack. And now I'm just gonna drone like a madman, except I get supply blocked again. That one. Oh no, I didn't. Psh. Right as I said that, my overlord finished. I'm very wary about Widow Mines. Very, 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 very wary. And anytime he stems or anything, that hurts him a lot. He just stemmed twice. Yeah, keep this in mind. He just stemmed twice without medivacs, right? So... not too bad for me. Need to be a little more active with my mutas, and I'm going to hive tech. I'm going to transition straight to hive. I'm going to go double melee upgrades, and just go straight to hive. That was close, but I still haven't lost a muta. And he has to worry about all ins. He can't scout me because I have map control. I need to do a much better job spreading out overlords, though. One of the big strengths of this is if you're vigilant, you can stop drops. Why do I have... did I, like, not rally my drones or something? What's going on? Okay, now, usually I can delay this third a bit longer, so he did a good job with that. I'm gonna give him some credit. Complete. I never got the melee, my first plus one melee. That's so bad, man. Like, oh my god, that's a huge mistake. It's probably not quite as important as the carapace, but still, that is a colossal mistake that I made. Okay, so notice, my mutas didn't do any damage. I'm not happy about where I am in this game, but it could be worse, for sure. Evolution complete. And I have Ultra Tech going down, I'm a base up. I mean, you know, all in all, this isn't too bad. It's just, I'm used to being a bit more ahead at this point sometimes. Okay, I didn't see the drop happen. I shouldn't lose this base. It's kind of annoying, not gonna lie, but trying to do sneaky things with backstabs and stuff, so alright, now I'm gonna leave these mutas here and hopefully I'll be a bit better about seeing any drops that come in. Alright. Oh my god. Ha! Huh. My plus one is delayed again. Did you see that? I accidentally put it in that Evo chamber. I should be fucked now. Like, I should have plus two melee done right now, and I don't even have plus one started. It's hard to describe just how bad of a screw-up that is. Like, oh my god. I mean, I spent the freaking money on it. I'm gonna have to play so well to win this now. This is insane. It is not because of the build. Like, that's such a big mistake. Alright, I have Carapace, so Zerglings by themselves are completely useless because I have. Oh! Aha! Aha! That's exactly what I have to be on the lookout for. Yes, get done so I can start plus two melee. So gross, man. It's just so bad. Ah, okay, cool. I'm just gonna take some of this armory. Mineral field depleted. Mineral field depleted. Okay, good. Spotted another drop, so I'm just gonna take a small force up there.